In this video, we'll learn about the meaning of the terms economic growth, economic development, and sustainability. Before we begin, let's try a sample question. When the red bar fills the screen, your time is up. Pause the video after I read the question to have more time. If a country's real GDP doubles, then it definitely means A, everyone in the country has doubled their income, B, everyone in the country is richer, C, everyone's standard of living has improved, D, everyone has a better job, or E, none of the above. The correct answer is E. To learn why, we have to understand the three concepts discussed earlier. I'll come back to this question at the end of the video. Let's start with the first concept, economic growth. Economic growth occurs when the real GDP of a country rises or its productive potential increases, as shown on the right in the diagram. Economic growth is only concerned with increasing real GDP or productive potential. It's an objective measure of the size of an economy and does not include a variety of other factors that influence the standard of living in a country. Economic development is a more holistic view of the economy and accounts for improvements in the standard of living and the quality of life in a country. It includes economic growth, but is about much more. It includes the quality of the environment, education opportunities and attainment, access to sufficient health care and life expectancy, political freedom and other key freedoms as well. If we look only at the economic growth of an economy, we are failing to see the bigger picture. It is improvements across these areas, as well as others, that will fundamentally increase the well-being and standard of living for the residents of a country. Sustainability is concerned with the use of resources by current generations, not compromising future generations. What that means is that the environment should be protected for future generations. Resources should also be used in a manner that does not disadvantage future generations. For example, a country should not exhaust all of its resources in becoming wealthy immediately. In doing so, they could harm the ability of future generations to benefit from these resources. Also, if by exhausting all resources the environment is irreversibly damaged, then it can harm the quality of life for future generations as well. Understanding this, let's go back to the earlier multiple choice question. We should be able to figure this out now. Real GDP doubling just means there's been growth in the amount of goods and services produced. That doesn't necessarily mean every single individual in a country has improved their economic position. Some will definitely have increased incomes, become richer, or improve their standard of living. Some will also get better jobs, but there will also be a group of people who may have stagnant incomes and even some who are worse off. Incomes may be rising for the more educated group of a population, but falling for those on the lower end of the economic scale. Understanding this question is key when understanding the difference between economic growth and economic development. Having explored the previous question further, you should have developed a stronger understanding of economic growth, development, and sustainability. These concepts will be useful to us as we progress through this section on the macroeconomy. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.